Welcome to the Dynamics CRM 2011 Creating Dialogs Workshop. This course will cover the options and functionality you have when creating dialogs within Dynamics CRM. The agenda for the workshop is to discuss the business process options in Dynamics CRM. Then we will look at the differences between workflows and dialogs to see when you would use one over the other. Then we'll take a detailed look at the options you have when creating dialogs. Business processes are an important part of a solution. Being able to automate and control the flow of the process is key to user adoption of the system, as well as making sure the right information is getting into the system. Dynamics CRM has two types of processes. We have automated processes that are based on actions or results of working in the system, and we have interactive processes that are initiated and run by the end user. Automated processes consist of workflow, custom workflow activities, and plugins. Interactive processes consist of dialogs. Looking at the differences between workflows and dialogs, workflows can be started by a user or can be automatically triggered. Workflows are asynchronous processes and do not require user input to run to completion. These processes will run in the background. When a workflow is triggered, a record is created on the async operations base table, and the asynchronous service will pick up that request to process the workflow. Both Windows Workflow Foundation 4 and 3.5 are supported for custom workflow activities, and workflows that are created outside or updated outside of Microsoft Dynamics CRM by updating the underlying XAML file is supported with workflows. Looking at dialogs, dialogs are started by a user, they need user action to continue processing, and they need user action to complete the dialogue. Dialogs are synchronous processes. They require that user action in order to complete. When you run these processes, a wizard-like interface is presented to the user so they can take appropriate actions to run the dialogue. The entity that stores information generated by running a dialogue is the process session entity. Only Windows Workflow Foundation 4 is supported with custom workflow activities. And dialogs that are updated or created outside of Dynamics CRM by updating the XAML file is not supported with dialogs. So what is a dialog? Well, a dialog is kind of like a conversation, a guide, or a call script. So if you think of customers that are doing cold calling, they may want to have a script that their end users will go through so each call is consistent, recording the same amount of data, asking the same questions. And so a dialog will give you that functionality to script out a conversation or even offer some training depending on your scenario. A dialog contains a prompt and response. So on the wizard that pops up, you'll have a prompt, so asking the user to ask something or do something, and then they record their responses. And you have the option to record the response or to not record the response depending on your needs. And then also within the wizard, you'll see a tip section. You can enter in information for your end users so they know what they should do on this page if the question isn't clear. So initiating a dialogue, you need to initiate a dialogue from an actual record in CRM. So you have to either be on an account record or an opportunity or one of your custom entities. It actually has to start from somewhere. Once you have a record selected, you'll have an option at the top to start dialogue, and then you can pick from any of the dialogues that are created for that type of entity that you're on. And then you can have child dialogues that once your parent dialogue triggers and you maybe answer some questions, that may trigger a child dialogue to appear and continue the processing. So as we get into creating dialogues, you'll notice that there's a lot of similar functionality within workflow. So if you're familiar with building workflows, you'll see a lot of the same options. But there will be a few new options that you'll see here. And the four new ones that you'll see are query CRM data, assign value, link child dialogue, and stop dialogue. So query CRM data, that allows you to actually query data within CRM. So one of your prompt pages could say, you know, enter in a last name of the contact. You can enter in the last name, hit next, and that'll actually go out and query your contact database and return back anyone that has that last name. So dialogues are pretty powerful that way, because you can actually pull data from the system, and then depending on some of your prompts and responses, you can even trigger workflows or things to go update the system after that dialogue is completed. Assign value. So we'll talk a little bit more about this in another slide, but assign value allows you to set different variables during the dialogue so you can kind of keep track of a certain score or a certain value throughout that dialogue and then use it at a later time. Link child dialogue is very similar to the child workflow. It's basically you're just linking another dialogue to the parent, and then that child dialogue can then continue on from the parent. And we'll go through an example of that in the demo. And then stop dialogue, obviously very similar to the stop workflow, is you at some point if your question, maybe the answer is no to one of the questions or a certain value, you can actually stop the dialogue at that point and not continue on. And then you'll have some of the other normal options that you'll see within the dialogues that are very similar to the workflow, like the create record, update record, assign record, send email, change status, etc. So those are the same options you'll see within workflow. You can use those within dialogues too. And then you can use custom workflow activities. So if you build your own custom workflow activity and you register that into CRM, you could use that on your dialogue. So as you get into building dialogues, you might run into a few limitations. And depending on what version you're on, if you're running Dynamics CRM 2011 before update rollout 5, you'll run into a couple limitations around hyperlinking. So the hyperlinks are static and you can't actually have a dynamic hyperlink. Well, those options were added after update rollout 5. Same thing with date time. So date time was not an option within the dialog. That is now after update rollout 5. A couple other limitations or things you might run into that you may need to work around is a child dialog cannot be an intermediate step. So you can't launch a child dialog and then come back to the parent dialog. Once you go into that child dialogue, that parent dialogue is done and you need to continue on. So as you think about that, if you have a scenario like that, you may have to have a few dialogues that link together to get the scenario that you want. And then, like I already mentioned, dialogues need to be started from a record. So there's some scenarios where maybe you want to just start a dialogue that doesn't have to be from a record. Well, if it is the case, you could look at creating a custom entity to run the dialogue off of, or maybe the user entity, or something that would allow you to start the dialogue and then create records from there. So there are some workarounds, there's some blog posts too that talk about some different ideas, but there is a couple limitations there just to keep in mind. So for variables and input arguments, a variable is a temporary data storage, and you can select a certain data type. There's I think 5 or 6 different data types that you can choose from, so like string, integer, and so forth. And so what this allows you to do is during your dialogue, you'll be able to store a value or hold different values that could be the result of a response from the end user. So for example, if I had a credit scoring application or a dialogue or a lead qualification, I might want to keep track of, as they're answering questions, assigning certain values to those questions. So if they answer yes or no or a certain dollar amount, I may want to increase their score. Well, I can keep track of that score in a variable. And then at the end, I could use that variable to determine, are they approved, are they qualified, and so forth. Input arguments, they are only used when you want to pass information into a child dialogue. If you're going to use an input argument, that dialogue needs to be a child dialogue, because then the parent dialogue will pass in an input argument into that child dialogue to continue processing. So if we wanted to pass that credit score in as an input argument into the child dialogue, then that child dialogue can take that score and continue on with that through its dialogue. Another option you'll notice in the dialogue is lookup response types. So within the dialogue, you can actually have a lookup for in a contact or an account or opportunity, or depending on what you want, you can actually look up data within the system. So this is a little bit different than the query step I talked about earlier, where this is you actually have a lookup field right in your dialogue. That gives you the lookup functionality you have in CRM. The key thing to keep in mind with this is when you go to add a lookup response to your dialogue, it's going to ask you what entity and basically what field on that entity is the lookup field. So normally you'd probably think right away that, if I want to look up for the account, I want to go choose the account entity. Well, depending on what you want to look up, we need to use the current lookup fields that are in the system. So for example, if I am going to go look up an account, I have two options. I can choose account or I could choose contact, because both of them have a lookup to an account record in the schema already. Another example of this would be contact, where if I wanted to have a lookup for a contact, I'd want to choose the account entity because that has a primary contact lookup right on the account. We'll go through a little bit more of this on the demo to make it hopefully help understand it a little bit better, but just kind of keep in mind that you need to pick an entity that has a lookup for the field that you want to go look up. And then that should hopefully help you in this list, in this slide here. Hopefully it would help if some of the common scenarios like account, you could use account and then the parent account lookup. Opportunity, you could use the opportunity relationship entity and then use the opportunity field for that one. So those are some of the common ones, but obviously there's other scenarios too. So as far as monitoring dialogues, very similar to workflows, where once a dialog is run on a record, you can see the dialog session right from with that record. So if you open up that record, you can go in and look at all the dialogues that have run on that record, and then even go into the dialog session and see what responses were stored, maybe what the end user typed in when they did their query CRM data. You can kind of see all that history within that dialog. So it's just like a workflow, you kind of see that history. The same thing goes with a dialog. The one thing with a dialog is you'll see a few different statuses of in progress, canceled, or completed. So cancel would be they actually exited out of the dialogue before it got to the last page or actually stopped the dialogue. And then completed, they made it all the way through the dialogue successfully. So let's go ahead. We're going to jump into the demo of the dialogues, and we'll see how we can create the dialogues, the different functionality and options you have when creating a dialogue. Hopefully that'll give you some good baseline understanding and help in some of your scenarios that you may have use for dialogues. To start the demo, we will first look at a dialogue that I have set up so you can see what types of functionality you can include in a dialogue. Then we'll go ahead and recreate the dialogue so you can see the options you may use in your own dialogues. For my dialogue, I have it based off a phone call. When an agent gets a phone call, they can trigger this dialogue. The dialogue will allow them to search for a contact record or create one if one is not found. Then it will launch a credit application process to score the contact and see if they are approved or declined credit. So if I go ahead and go over to my activities, I'm going to go ahead and just create a new phone call. I'm just going to save it. So once I have a phone call record saved, I can go ahead and then launch my dialogue. So if I click on Process, Start Dialogue, I can choose any of the dialogues that are based off a phone call, which I have one here. So when that dialogue launches, the first thing I'm asked for is enter the last name. So this is basically going to search the contacts. So for example, if I type in just a couple letters and hit next, it'll go ahead and see that it looks like I don't have any contacts with the letter CO in their last name. I can go back and I could search again, click next, and here I see I have a few contacts with the last name Smith. So I could go ahead and select one of those contacts, and then what I did here is I have an option to say, you know, do we need to create a new contact, or no, that I found the contact in the system. And the reason I'm using this, you'll see later on when we actually go to design it, is there's a conditional statement this is using, or is used for that conditional statement. So in this case, we found the contact we're talking with. I'll go ahead and hit next. And I also put this page in here is basically just a way to show the contact that I selected and how you can actually hyperlink. So I actually have a hyperlink back to that contact record. So if I click on this, I actually can get right to that contact record from within the dialog. Also, since I selected that contact, I mentioned we were going to actually jump into a credit application. So I actually have an entity within the system that's called credit application, and it's creating a new record. And that record is going to hold some of the responses I get from the customer. So what I can do now is if I click on this, basically launch the credit application here. And so from here, you can see that right now I've only have basically the contact's name in the credit application. There's some blank fields at this point. Those will get updated later, so we'll check that out here as we move through the process. So I have my contact, I have everything here. I'll just go ahead and hit next. And so now I have a few questions I need to ask the customer on the phone. So how old are you? So let's just say they're 25. What is your birth date? So they can, you know, you can put in a birth date. And then annual revenue, that's 30,000. I'll go ahead and hit next. And you see from the responses of that first dialogue there, I get back a credit score. And my credit score was 8. And then again here I have a link back to that credit application. So if I click on that, You can see now that these fields have been filled in, and also with the approval status of accepted. So if we go to one more page here, actually have a next page that says you have been accepted. So basically it's actually looking at the values within the dialog, looking at the answers given by the customer, and determining if they were approved or denied. So if I hit next here and hit finish, that ends the dialog. If I hit F5 on the phone call record, I actually have some fields being updated as well. So now I have the recipient in the phone call, I have the subject, I have their phone number, and then also I have the link to the credit application as well. So as you can see with Dialogs, you can do a lot of things as far as creating records, updating records, and so forth. So there's definitely a lot of functionality within the Dialogs. Let's go ahead and show you one more option that I have within this dialog before we go in and actually create it. So I'm going to save my phone call. All right, so there again I have a phone call record. I'm going to go ahead and start that same dialog. This time, let's just say I don't find the contact. What I did here, and you'll see when we go and create this, is I actually have a contact record in the system called Create New Contact. And the reason I did that is because when you have a lookup field, you actually have to select something, and there isn't a way to have a blank value. So I just kind of made this show up for every query. That way, if the query for CO doesn't show up any records, this is still going to show up because I'm having that put in there all the time. And you'll see that when we go ahead and go through and recreate the dialog. And so then I have the option, do you need to create a new contact? So yes, I need to create a new contact. And so instead of just showing me the contact information like we did last time, now I actually get to go through and create the contact record. So what company? So let's just say they are already an existing company. We'll go ahead and pick Alpine here. What's your first name? Tom. What's your last name? Johnson. Work phone number. Say they're in Denver. Street address. State. And zip. All these are prompts within the dialog, so you can really customize it to be whatever you need to populate a contact record. So I'm going to hit next. As that goes through, it says created contact Tom Johnson. So basically pulling the full name back. It has the link to the contact record as well as the credit application again. So we just created this new contact record. So if I click on it, I can actually get access to it in case I need to fill in any more information. And same with the credit application. I can go ahead and click on that as well. But so if I go ahead and click next, I get back to the same questions here. Let's just say 17, birthday, and then annual revenue, let's just say 10,000. Let's go ahead and hit next here. So the credit score was -8. And again, I can get to the application record if I want to see the credit application. If I click next, it says you have been declined. Finish. Again, if I hit F5 on the record we already had open, again, that pulls that information back into here with a link back to the credit application. So I click on that, I can see the results from the dialog that we put in. So that was just kind of showing you two different ways of one dialog being able to branch out depending on the answers you use within the dialog can go two separate ways through the dialog. So let's go ahead and take a look at how we created this dialog. For the second dialog, we'll go ahead and create a new record here. This one will be the create or search contact dialog. And in this case, I'm going to launch this one off of a phone call record. And then again, will be a dialog. And this one will be an on-demand. This is going to be the one that starts our actual dialog. So to start with, again, I'm going to go ahead and go down and add a page. And this is going to be the contact search page. And we'll add a prompt and response here. I'll call this enter last name. And in the prompt text, we'll just say, and this response type is going to be single line text. And we'll go ahead and hit save and close. So now when basically the user that's typing in the last name puts that in there, hits next, we want to be able to take that value and go search the CRM database for an option that meets that criteria. So in order to do that, we're going to need, if I select the page back here, we're going to need a query CRM data step. So when I choose query CRM data, I'll give this one a name, just call it query contacts. We'll hit set properties, and we'll get the normal kind of advanced find window here. In this case, what it's going to do is we're going to search on last name, and then instead of equals, I'm going to do contains. I want them to be able to type in just a few letters and be able to find a contacts to look through. The other thing that you can do at this point is when those contacts are displayed, it's going to use this view, so full name, business phone. That may not be enough information for them to determine the actual contact. So I may want to add a few other columns. So I could add an email address, and then we could do, I guess we could do city. So I'll just put those in there for now. And then you can rearrange them if you want. So just say okay. So as long as those fields are added to that query, then those values will be available to show in the results of the dialog. Now, last name contains, basically we're not gonna know what to search on. So you can just make a variable or a parameter. We can really call it whatever you want. So just say it's parameter one. And then what you're gonna do is actually click on this modify query variables. And when you do that, it's actually going to allow you to take any of the variables you have from the design tab and actually then dynamically set them. And so this is where we're going to come in and say, we want the enter last name step. So enter last name is the actual response that we're going to get from the end user. So we're going to go ahead and put that in there. And actually, I'm just going to remove out my parameter one there. So now we basically just set this as the variable for our last name contains. One thing to keep in mind is if you come back into this step and you go back to the design view because maybe you need to add some additional fields, and you come back here, when you go back to the query variables, it's going to reset. So you're going to need to reset your variables here if you should happen to have to go back to that design tab. So I'm going to set that. I'll hit save and close. Now with that query, we're going to go ahead and add another page because now we want to display the responses, or basically the results from the query. And so this page, we're just going to have them select contact page. We'll add a prompt and response. And so here we have the prompt text will just be select contact. And this, we're basically going to have the response be a pick list set. So the results are going to be show up in a pick list. However, where we're going to get the results from is actually by querying CRM data. So if we choose this option to query CRM data, you'll see that you can actually get access to any query steps you have within your dialog. So if you had, 2, 3, 4, 5, whatever query steps in there, you could access any one of those queries and have them show up in certain parts of your dialog. So I'm going to say query contacts, and here's where you can see all the fields we selected when we were creating that query. So you can come in here and you can select whichever field you want. So you don't have to select them all. Maybe just a few would be enough. And then you can choose how you want to separate them, because right now they would show up all together. I'm just going to do a /space. And you see the preview is they'll kind of split out that way. We also could do another split like that, so you can see however you want them to be displayed. So I'll go ahead and save and close there. And then I'm going to go ahead and add another step to be prompt and response. Because if the contact's not found, I want some way to know that I need to actually branch off and go create a new contact. And this time I'm actually going to use the option set radio button, so basically just a yes or no. And I'm just going to define the values right here within the dialog. So let's do that. So I have a couple options there. And we'll hit save and close. And one thing I'm actually going to do, I forgot to do when we were actually doing the query, is in my query here right now, I'm just saying if last name contains this, the user value, I also want to add where last name equals create new contact. So this is where I mentioned earlier where I actually have a contact in the system that's called create as the first name and new contact as the last name. So basically what this is going to do is it's always going to show that contact no matter what. It's going to meet that criteria. Fix my variable over here. Enter last name, response text. Okay, so I'm going to leave that one because I actually want it to say new contact there. Okay, so now I've fixed that up here. So I have my pages with my two options at the I'm going to present to the end user. So now, depending on the response I get from this question, whether they found the contact or need to create a new one, I need to be able to branch off of that. So what I'm going to do is create a check condition. In that check condition, we're just basically going to check the response. So So option to create a new contact equals 0. So 0 was to create a new contact, and 1 was to add if they found it. So actually, let's do the 1 first. We'll start with that one. So option to create a new contact, 1. So that means we're not going to create a new contact. We're going to use the one that they select. Since that is chosen, then we're actually going to create the credit application record for that contact. So let's go ahead and add a step, create record. So in the create record here is we're going to create, and this is where the name is going to get key, because we're going to have a couple steps that kind of are the same thing, but they're in different paths of the dialog. So we're going to create the credit application. And here we're going to set properties. And this is actually where we're going to set the contact name. And so we're actually going to choose the select contact from list. That's actually the step that the end users, or the user running the dialog, is going to select the contact. And then we're just going to choose contact. So that's going to be that name of the contact. And then I'm also going to just put in the name field here, select contact. And let's do full name. Let's add that here. Let's save and close. So now the credit application record would be created. What I also want to do is, you remember the phone call record also got updated while this dialog ran. So I'm going to choose the option for update record. And now I'm just going to call this one update phone call. Hit set properties. And in this one, we're going to, the recipient will be that contact that we selected. The phone number, you can pull that in. The business phone, and then we're actually going to set the credit application as well, so that will allow that to link together. And then in the subject we can put credit application 4, and we can pull in the select contact from list. We can get to the contact's full name. We'll add that in there. So with dynamic values, you can pretty much set, you know, anything you want. Let's save and close. So now at this point, we have the credit application record created, we have a contact selected, the phone call is updated. We could then, I had in my original dialog a page that displayed, here's the contact you selected, and here's the link to the credit application. But since I already showed how to do the hyperlink, I'll go ahead and skip that just to save on some time. And what we're going to do now is from right after this step is we're actually going to launch into the child dialogs. We actually want to pass the contact information and the credit application over. We already set the contact on the application. Now we just need to move that credit application over to the next dialog. And that was that dialog we already created for the approval process. So I don't want to go ahead and recreate that whole dialog again in here. I just want to call that as a child dialog. So in order to do that, I'm actually going to go back out to my original dialog we created. I'm going to go ahead and deactivate it so we can make some changes to it. And then actually I'm going to choose the option for as a child process. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to have an input parameter, and this will be the credit application. We'll just call it ID. And this is going to be a lookup, and the lookup is going to go to the phone call credit application, because you saw that I had a lookup field on the phone call that linked my phone call to the credit application. That was a custom relationship I set up. And now that I have that set up, I can use that in this lookup. Because basically what we need is we need to be able to pass that application, or that we created that record over in the other dialog. This new dialog that we're going to call, the child dialog, needs to be able to take that and continue on and know that application is the right one to update, so we know which one it is. So that is set there for now. So I'm just going to save and close this. Now I'm going to go back to our other parent dialog. And I'm going to go ahead and add a step to link child dialog. Link to approval dialog. And then we're going to link it to the credit application. And then if we pull this up, we'll have the credit approval demo, one that we set up. And then you're going to want to hit set properties, because here's where you can actually set what value you're going to pass over to that credit application ID, or basically what value you're going to pass over to the input argument that you set up. And so in this instance, we're actually going to go and choose the step that we use to create the credit application record, and we're going to choose the credit application. So we want to pass that over to the next dialog. So now that is set. So now basically what we have here is, as long as we select the existing contact, it should launch into that trial dialog and continue on with the process. But what we don't have now is, what if we need to create a new contact? So if I click that if statement up here and just add a default action, so if it isn't equal to 1, then we want to do this step. So the first thing we need to do then is we need to prompt the user with what information we need to get to be able to create the contact record. So in order to do that, we need to create a page. Let's call this one create contact page. And then we'll add some prompt and responses to this one. And to save on time, I won't add everything what we did before, but what I want to add is, let's add the company lookup. We haven't showed that one yet. So a lookup option, we can do company do you work for? And then for the response type, we'll actually choose lookup. And the thing to note with a lookup that we talked about during the slides is, if you're going to look up an account, your first instinct is, well, I'm going to choose account from this entity. And then you come here and you look at, like, okay, you know, parent account actually would work. But the one thing you want to keep in mind is, if you're using a lookup, you actually need to have an entity that actually has a lookup field for that record you want to look up. So for example, if I chose contact, a contact does have a parent customer field, which does allow me to look up an account. I think it also does account and contact, so you actually could do both there. But that's kind of one thing to keep in mind is, in order to get a lookup for an entity, you need to choose an entity that has a lookup for that specific entity already. So it sounds a little confusing, but once you start using it, you'll get the hang of it as well. So we'll do that one, and then let's do another prompt and response. We're going to need last name. Then we want single line text. And another example is, if you need to insert a prompt before that one, you can do insert before, just like in a workflow. And you can't move things around. That's kind of one pain point, but at least you have the option to select and then add above. And so now I can do first name, because maybe it actually makes more sense to get the first name first. And again, we'll do single line text response. I'll leave it at that for now. My other dialog did a bunch of other fields, but for time purposes, we'll just go ahead and move on. So after we have this page created and getting those results for the contact, we actually want to go ahead and create the contact. I go back to insert after. Again, I'm going to select my page, do add step, create record. And this will be contact. And then when we go to set properties, again, you'll see that now we'll have access to the fields from our dialog. So if I come down here, I have the first name, response text, we can add that in there, last name, response text, and then let's see, company, parent customer, company account, okay. So I could bring in a few other ones there, but we'll just do that for now. So now I have the contact record created. I then need to, since we're going down a different path here, notice up here we actually created the credit application. Well, if we hit this path, we don't have the credit application created yet. So we need to do that. So we need to create record. I'll call this one create credit application for new contact record. New credit application. And then we'll set the properties on this one again. We'll just set the primary contact. This time, what we're actually going to want, though, is, instead of choosing the select contact from list, we want the create new contact record contact, because that's going to be the new contact that gets created by the dialog. So we want to fill that one in, and then we'll grab the full name as well, just to put that in there. Save and close. So now we have the credit application created. We want to update the phone call with that information. Update phone call, set properties, and we'll update the recipient. And again, this one will be from the create new contact record. The business phone, we won't have that one since we shortened up the dialog. We don't have that right now. Subject, default the full name in there. And then we'll link back to the credit application. So create credit application for new contact record. So that's the second one that we created. again, this is where the naming is key, because as you can see, the list starts to get quite long once you start having a bunch of steps and items within your dialog. So save and close. Now we can actually have that confirmation page where we could show, here's the contact we created, here's the link to the contact record, to the credit application. But I'll go ahead and skip that since I already kind of demoed that already. We can then launch into the child dialog from here. So link child dialog, do that, and then we're going to link to the credit application, credit demo. And again, we'll set properties, and we'll pass over our credit application. So this time, instead of selecting the original credit application for existing contact, we want to do it for the new contacts. Make sure we get the right one. So I'll save and close that. And so there we have our dialog set up now. So I have basically what we demoed earlier, where we have the contact search page, queries the contacts. The contacts are returned. You can select one from the list. If you do, and you don't need to create a new one, it'll go through, create the credit application, update the phone call, and then launch into the credit application dialog. Otherwise, it'll go through the steps of creating a contact and then launch into the credit application. So as you can see, the dialogs are pretty in-depth as far as the functionality you have and things you can do. It can take some time to build them. So the best thing to do is to actually kind of think out through your process what you want in the dialog, where you want the steps. And you know, if you have dialogs that can be grouped together, so like example, my credit application one, it could be used by multiple dialogs, so you can make them as child. That would save you some steps when it comes to modifying, you know, a dialog. You don't have to modify a bunch. You can just go modify that one and just use it as a child that can call from the other dialogs. And before we test out our dialog, there's one step I know I missed here. If I go back into my query, where I actually query for the contact record, and go back over to the advanced find view here, I forgot to add the or statement here, because otherwise with this, we're not going to get any responses or results back from our query, because I want to get either the last name that contains the parameter from the end user or the last name equals new contact. So now that I have that set, I'm going to go back to my query variables and make sure I reset this. That'll be to the last name response text. And I'll save and close. So now we should be ready to test this out. So I'm going to go ahead and save and close this. I'm going to select both our demo dialogues that we just did and activate them. If you're making changes to the parent or the child dialog, it's kind of best practice to disable both of them and then re-enable them, because that way they should be able to pick up any changes, especially if you're changing some of the input parameters and things like that. You're going to need to update both anyways. So let's go ahead and create a new phone call record. Let's see if our new dialog is working right. Click Start Dialog and choose our demo one we just set up. We'll enter last name. Next, it comes back with some results. So I could select one of those results, or I could select the new contact option, which I mentioned is just kind of a dummy record in the system, so I can just have something to choose. So let's just go ahead and choose one that's here. I say no, we found the contact in the list. And now it jumps over to our initial dialog we first set up, the credit application. So now we can enter in that information. Next, and we get our results. And we've been accepted. Next, click finish. I'll hit F5. Our phone call is updated successfully, and we can go ahead. I'll hit save and new. We'll just walk through the dialog quickly. The other option of creating a new contact, make sure that works. So we'll start dialog. We'll start the same dialog again. This time we don't have any contacts, so yes, we need to create one. Here's our lookup. Lookup is going to the company for the account. First name, last name, click next. Again, it jumps over to the child dialog now. Say 17, just pick a date there, say 10,000. And so now our score is negative 13. We do have the link to the credit application, and we've been declined. So it looks like, you know, that everything's working fine at that dialog. So hopefully from this demo here, you saw there are many different ways you can use dialogs, from the different steps you have with the check conditions, the pages and with the prompt and responses, querying CRM data, creating records, updating records, There's a few things we didn't use, like assign records, send email, and change status, but those are basically just like you would do with workflow. You can change the status or assign the record to someone else. And then we also did the, you know, link child dialogs. Hopefully that information gets you a base knowledge of some of the dialog functionality so you can start building your own dialogs. There are a number of dialog resources out on the web. There's many videos on YouTube and a number of examples in blog posts for different scenarios that other partners have run into. Things like survey examples, service examples, how to use different options within the dialogs. So here's a list of some of those good resources. So with that, I want to say thank you for attending today's workshop. I hope you at least got a good base understanding of dialogs to get started with some of your scenarios. Thank you.